Well, good morning, everyone. This is Pastor Carlos Rivera in Richmond, Virginia. God bless you. Good morning. Good morning. Rise and shine. This is the day the Lord has made. We're going to rejoice and we're going to be glad in it. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Lord. You know, it's always good to get together with my brothers and sisters every morning just to gather around God's word and, of course, pray together. And Louis Alvarez, you're the first one on the line, my brother. Zaida Preston, God bless you. Nainin, good morning, good morning. Lisa, good to see you. Glad you made it. Kathy Martin, God bless you, my sister. Elizabeth Albano's coming on right now. Dennis Lopez, good morning, my prayer warriors. Amen. I love that. Sharon Johnson, Hilda Bryant, good morning, cousin. Glad you're on board with us this morning as well. Yvette Sanders is watching. Elizabeth Albano, yes, good morning, good morning. Amen, amen. It is a good, good morning. Peggy Stevens, good to have you with us this morning. Carmelo Vasquez is on board. Sharon Johnson, good morning. Elisa Alvarez, good morning, my dear. God bless you, glad you made it. Lynn Bell, hallelujah, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Yvette Sanders, Ivy McNeil, amen, amen. Good morning, everyone. Yvonne Harrison is on board with us. Peggy Morningstar, what a cool name. Kim Cooper, yes, good morning, good morning. Yes, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, road test for tomorrow. Yes, we'll pray for you, Elizabeth. We'll pray for you to make sure you get past that test, amen. And Louis Alvarez as well, good, God bless you. Listen, it's a great day, amen. It's a beautiful day, and we have a lot of good things in store for today. Venice Skinner, so glad you made it with us as well. Adrian Mitchell, I know who you are now. Yvonne Harrison, good morning as well. Praise God. Well, the rest of the team is coming on board right now. I want to go ahead and get started this morning. Yes, amen. And I want to call our time together, this gathering, I've entitled it, The Power of Prayer. Power of Prayer. Amen. Amen. And look at, turn your Bible if you have it with you, or just make a note of this. Matthew chapter 6, verse 6. Matthew 6, verse 6 says this. But you, when you pray, go into your room, and when you have shut your door, pray to your Father who is in the secret place, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you openly, will reward you openly. That's amazing, right? What a lot of times what we see manifested in the physical was actually one, you know, when you actually see it, it was actually one in private. See, by the time it actually manifests itself so that others can see it, people have no idea what it cost you, amen, behind the scenes. Sometimes the prayer, the power of prayer to be behind the scenes, interceding for people, asking God to help us in areas of our lives, amen. And you see, prayer, if you're taking notes, write this down. Prayer enables you to do what we cannot do. That's right. Prayer enables you to do what you cannot do. See, a habit of prayer brings great encouragement to the one who prays. That's right. The more time you spend in prayer, which means it's the more time you spend with God, amen, connecting to him, then the byproduct of that is encouragement. We feel encouraged. We feel lifted up, amen, when we spend time with the Lord, because that's God's presence in our lives. And his presence always brings encouragement, always empowers us to continue going forward, amen. Even when times are challenging, even when times are difficult, prayer enables you to do what you cannot do. See, in the Bible, we see that prayer moved God to raise people from the dead, to heal the sick, to save souls, to draw water from a rock, amen, to send bread down from heaven, amen. And you see, we see the supernatural that's attached to prayer. That's right. If you want to see the supernatural power of God moving your life, then prayer is the key. See, prayer even made the sun stand still. That's right. In the midst of a battle, they prayed that the sun would stop, and it stood still so they could win the battle. See, the fact that prayer moves God to action should be encouraging to all of us. That's right. See, when we pray, it actually enables God. It actually gives God access to our lives, amen? And not just access, but it gives God permission to move on our behalf. And see, God wants to do that. God wants to be able to bless us. God wants to be able to strengthen us. And the key is through prayer. See, the prayer is the channel that draws all those things into our lives. See, especially through difficult times. See, we find ourselves seeking God to lift the burden and lighten our load, and He does. See, that's really the key. This whole season that we've been in with this virus and everything else, it's been challenging. I can't even tell you, but it feels like we're coming to the other side of it, you know? And even though there's a lot of things happening in this world that are very disruptive, you know, I don't know about you, but staying connected to God throughout this whole time together has been such an encouragement for me personally, amen? And you see, I think a lot of times, you know, we pray for certain things to happen in our lives. But one thing I want you to know, and one thing I believe that we need to pray for, don't pray for easy lives. Pray to become stronger people. Oh, come on, somebody. Listen, don't pray for easy lives. Pray to become stronger people. Because it's not always gonna be easy. As a matter of fact, it seems like it's picking up speed, getting more challenging every day. So instead of trying to ask God to put us in a comfort zone, ask God to stretch us and to make us stronger and to give us a bigger capacity to what's happening around us as well. And when we pray that way, man, God will strengthen you because see, the Lord, when you magnify the Lord and you pray and you seek Him, then God becomes bigger than all the circumstances around you. No matter how difficult they may seem, God is bigger and God is more than willing and able to handle all of our circumstances. Amen. Praise God. And you know, I really believe that part of that prayer and what happens during prayer is that God begins to download wisdom. That's right, man. Listen, write this down if you're taking notes. Depend on God's wisdom. Depend on God's wisdom. Look what Luke 21 verses 14 and 15 has to say. But make up your mind not to worry beforehand how you will defend yourselves. For I will give you words and wisdom that none of your adversaries will be able to resist or contradict. Man, that is such a powerful thing. What an assurance to know that when we get in circumstances where we have to confront people, that God not only gives us the words, but He gives us the wisdom. Amen. Listen, Jesus said you have received two gifts from God. That's right. Two gifts from God. Number one, your mouth. And number two, His wisdom. Oh, praise God. Listen, two gifts from God, your mouth and His wisdom. See, unexpected things may happen today, but don't worry. Don't be perplexed. You know, don't worry about things that are in the future. See, the Holy Spirit within you will rise to the occasion and speak through you. That's right. God promises that when we get in circumstances that we need to speak and to maybe we get pushed back into a corner or we face opposition from people, then God will give us the wisdom of what to say. And listen, He'll also give us the wisdom of what not to say. Come on, somebody. Sometimes it's wiser to not say anything. Amen. Sometimes saying nothing speaks louder than everything else because people will push you to the corner, maybe instigate and provoke you to try to do something, but staying cool, allowing the Holy Spirit to work in your life. Sometimes God's wisdom says speak, but other times it says just walk away. Sometimes God's word and God's wisdom leads us to a place that people are just blown away, like they were with the disciples when Peter and John were on their way to the temple, and of course they healed that man, right? That was a paralytic. Then when they said, silver and gold I have none, but what I have I give you in Jesus' name, get up and walk, right? See, when they did that, it created such a commotion that they were brought before the Sanhedrin, before the court per se, right? And of course, when they began to speak, they were amazed. They said, man, these folks are not learned. They're just ordinary people. They haven't been to the colleges that we have. They haven't gone to Pharisee University. Come on, somebody. But they spoke with such wisdom. Then they said, you know, these guys have been with Jesus When you've been with Jesus in prayer and God downloads wisdom, people will see wisdom inside of you that's way above what you think you have in you. Amen. And when God begins to speak through you, then people are amazed and they glorify God even when they don't know. So listen, relax. Don't be so uptight about situations you have to be in. Just pray before you go in. Allow the Holy Spirit to take over your heart and your mind. And I guarantee you, everything will work on your in your favor and on your behalf. See, someone greater than you is within you. Oh man, put that down in the chat. Put that down. Someone greater than me is in me. And when you understand that, when you can depend on God for that, and you realize that that is real, then man, you can walk with a certain confidence, a certain peace. You don't have to rehearse things in your mind all the time. Just allow God to flow through you. And I guarantee you, you will be able to get through anything depending on God's wisdom. And you see, depending on God's wisdom also leads you to something amazing. See, when you depend on God's wisdom, it makes you, it makes you decide to believe in miracles. That's right. God's wisdom gives us the power to believe in miracles. Write that down in the chat. Decide to believe in miracles. Mark chapter 9, verse 23 says this. Jesus said to him, if you can believe all things, I love this. If you can believe, all things are possible to him who believes. That's right. God's wisdom leads us to faith, to believe God. You see, believing produces a harvest of miracles. Oh, hallelujah. Listen, write that down. Put that in the chat right now. Believing produces a harvest of miracles. It sure does. Bible, Jesus said, if you believe, nothing will be impossible for you. You see, a miracle is something that's impossible, something that you can't make happen, that no one around you can't make happen. No matter how educated you are, no matter how gifted and talented you are, these are impossibilities that in the natural cannot happen. But when you decide to believe in miracles, when you decide to believe that God can do it, then God, that just enables, that releases God, that unleashes his power, amen, to intervene on your behalf. You see, a miracle is a supernatural intervention of God in the problems and situations of your life. That's right. See, God knows us individually, and he's got miracles and things that he's going to do for you that he's not going to do for anyone else. So you need specific things. I need specific things to happen, and God is so good to show up at the right time. Listen, I love the fact that believing in the power of God, when you believe in the power of God, you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. Absolutely. See, believing in the power of God, people think, man, I can only believe, but for so much. Listen, ask God to help you in your unbelief. Say, God, help me believe you for more. Help me to trust you for more. I want greater things in my life, in my family, people around me. And listen, just begin to pray that prayer to the Lord that God will give me the faith to believe and trust God for more. See, make a choice to trust God even when situations seem hopeless. As a matter of fact, can I just add this? We need to trust God especially when things are hopeless. That's right, especially when things are difficult, when walls in front of us look too big, when things around us look too challenging, when the enemy is constantly on our heels, when mountains surround us. Listen, at the end of the day, that's when God shows up in a miraculous way. Listen, he did it for Moses, amen. He did it for all kinds of people in the Bible. And guess what? He'll do it for you. And he'll do it for me as well. See, believe God through the circumstances, especially when they're hopeless. Listen, live in the potential of your faith, not the consequences of your doubt. Write that in the chat. Live in the potential of your faith, not in the consequences of your doubt. Because in faith, there's power, there's potential for the unstoppable, the things that can that are amazing, that can happen because of your faith. But there are many consequences in doubt. See, people that doubt really don't get very far when it comes to the things of God. the 12, you know, when they send out the 12 spies, 10 of them doubted. And because of that, it caused the children of Israel to be in the desert for 40 years. Listen, don't be a doubter. Be a believer. Decide to believe in miracles today. And you know, one of the greatest miracles that God gives every single one of us are relationships. People around us that love us and care for us, amen. What a wonderful gift God has given every single one of us. And listen, put this in the chat. Nurture true relationships. Nurture true relationships. Look what Proverbs chapter 18, verse 24 has to say. A man who has friends must himself be friendly, but there is a friend who sticks closer than a brother. That's right. Your relationship with God is so powerful. And you know, I love when it says that for a man who has friends, he himself must be friendly. So a lot of people say, well, I don't have friends and I don't have people around me. Well, let me ask you a question. How friendly are you? I mean, are you the kind of person that extends yourself to others, that shows hospitality? That are you the kind of person that reaches out to others? Because most people that have friends, guess what? They're friendly. I know that really sounds very elementary, but it's true. You know, if you feel lonely, then reach out to somebody else who's lonely, and guess what? Neither one of you will be lonely again. That's right. See, a real situation, I love this about friends, about nurturing real friends, especially when situations come up that are very difficult to deal with. You see, a real situation will expose a fake friend. That's right. When you get into a jam, who's standing with you? Come on, somebody. When you're going through something difficult, who are the people that stay there in the midst of the battle with you? Who are the people encouraging you when things are difficult? Listen, tough situations really do expose not just fake friends, but exposes real friends. Listen, do not, I'm gonna give you something very practical. Do not permit the name of a friend to be criticized in your presence. Absolutely. Listen, I remember as a very young Christian, I remember hearing other people in the church at gatherings, and they were talking negative things about the church, negative things about the pastors. And you know, I got so upset. I actually left the party early, but before I left, I told certain people that I heard over and over again, I walked up to them and said, you know, it's really a shame that you guys can sit around here talking negative about my pastor. Listen, if you don't like the church, why don't y'all just leave? Instead of being so negative. And I just left. Of course, I didn't make too many friends after that. Those people kind of didn't like me anymore. But I just didn't, it didn't matter. I felt so like, how dare you talk about my friend like that, my pastor? How dare you talk about anybody that I love and care for negatively in front of me? Do you think I'm just gonna sit there and be quiet? No, I absolutely not. Listen, don't embrace a slanderous report about a friend unless he's present to defend himself. That's right. When people start, you know, it's called gossip. When people start putting other people down, listen, if you're my friend, just know this. I'm going to stand up for you. I'm not going to tolerate that kind of talk. Come on, somebody. I'm just keeping it real, right? Being a friend is also being loyal to that person, not just trying to fit in with everybody. So you'll love them when you see them, but behind your back, you're entertaining other people who are their enemies. Listen, a trustworthy friend is worth any price, any effort, any defense. That's right. Absolutely, positively. Listen, remember this. This is so important. True friends will always have the same enemies. Man, write that down. True friends will always have the same enemies. That's right. Listen, if you have someone who's your enemy and I'm your friend, then your enemy is my enemy. Come on, somebody. I'm not gonna go entertaining their situation. I'm not gonna go spending time with them. I'm not gonna be taking selfies on Facebook with somebody that actually is one of your enemies. Why would I do that? That just shows that I'm really not your friend. I'm just keeping it real. Listen, people say and they believe all kind of stuff, but I believe friendship and true friendship always stands by your friend, even if you have to bear their reproach. Even if they did something that they fell short in, then people need to forgive, amen, and not criticize and not speak bad about others. But be, if you're really a Christian, you know what? Stop talking bad about people. Start talking to people, to God. Start talking to God about those people. You know, don't talk to others and pollute their minds and their ears. You know, I guess I'm keeping it real here, man. And maybe it gets to me here because I am so faithful to people and I'm loyal. I learned that, you know, growing up in the streets of Chicago, you had to be loyal to your friends and to the people that you know. So at the end of the day, be loyal to people. If you got somebody who's a friend, don't listen to negative things that other people speak about them. Defend them, amen, and speak. And of course, you know, I remember one person was talking negative about somebody else. I said, listen, I know you guys are criticizing this person. How about if I get them on the phone right now? Because the Bible says that if you have something against your brother, you should go and talk to them. How about if I get them on the phone right now so we could go ahead and air this out? And you know what? People shrink back. Because they don't, you know, they rather criticize, amen, than confront a situation and bring healing to it. Amen. Praise God. Listen, be a friend. Be a true friend. Listen, true friends discover and find and are surrounded by true friends as well. Amen. Be discerning about who you surround yourself with, but be that person that's a blessing to others. Amen. Well, praise God. I kind of went on a little bit long toward the end because God puts so much weight on friendships and on relationships. So we need to nurture those great people around us and those great relationships as well. Amen. Well, praise God. Listen, right now where you are, lift up your hands. Let's go ahead and begin to praise the Lord. Begin to give him glory and honor. Heavenly Father, we just thank you this morning. You are such a good God. You're such a wonderful God. And we just bless you and we praise you for you are our creator and our maker this morning. And in Jesus' name, oh God, I thank you that there's power in prayer. That every time we gather, you say when two or more gather that you'll be here, that when two or more touch and agree, oh God, that you'll get it done. So in Jesus' name, we know there's power in prayer, where there's power in unified prayer, Lord God. So Father, in the name of Jesus, unleash your power upon the circumstances that we're going through, oh God. Unleash your power upon the people that we'll be interceding for in a minute. Lord God, in Jesus' name, we know, Lord God, that we can depend on you. So Father, this morning we depend on your wisdom. Yes, God, download wisdom. You said in the book of James that if we ask for wisdom, that you'll give it to us liberally, Lord God. So we know that you'll give us plenty. When we ask, you'll download all the wisdom that we need. So in Jesus' name, give us wisdom this morning. Wisdom, oh God, to deal with whatever this day has in store. Wisdom to make the right decisions as well, Lord God. Wisdom to see things, Lord God, not just in the natural, but give us spiritual insight and discernment, Lord God, to understand your will. Wisdom, Lord God, to hear your Holy Spirit speak to us in the quietness of our hearts, oh God, and be able to obey through the power of the Holy Spirit. And Father God, today we've decided to believe in miracles. Hallelujah. We know we've seen them in the past. We see them now, oh God. And we know that you have miracles in store for the future. Help us to believe you, Lord God. Not just miracles for ourselves, but miracles for others as well, Lord God. Those that may not have the faith to believe, help us, Lord God, to be more than conquerors, to share more of ourselves and believe God for even greater things in other people's lives as well. And Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you and help us in our unbelief. If there's any doubt inside of us this morning, oh God, if there's anything that's wavering inside of us, that's being tossed to and fro, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, we put our hope and our trust in you this morning. And Father, we thank you and we praise you for the victory. We thank you, Lord God, for the miracles. And we thank you that what you're doing with us and for us is amazing. And Father God, help us to nurture good relationships. Help us to be a good friend to others. Help us to be friendly and inviting, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, you put so much weight on relationships. Help us to be that friend that sticks closer than a brother, just like you do to us, oh God. Help us to duplicate that here on earth as well, because we know that true friendships are not so easy to find, oh God. So in Jesus' name, help us to discover those friends, and also, Lord God, to maintain good relationships, Lord Father, in the name of Jesus. Bring friends around us, Lord God, that will stand for us even when we're not around, Lord God, that would not allow, Lord God, negativity to be spoken about us, Lord God, but they would defend us, Lord God. And we know that's a good friend, just like Jonathan defended David when Saul was putting David down. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord God, for the friendships that you've given us and the love that we can share and is shared with us through others, Father, in Jesus' name. So listen, right now, let's go ahead and pray. Let's pray over our prayer requests. Amen. If you brought your prayer list with you, go ahead and lay hands on that right now. We're just going to believe God for just miracles in people's lives right now. We're just going to declare it and believe it. We're going to join our faith right now. Heavenly Father, we know in Jesus' name that your word says that when we touch and agree. So today we pray the prayer of agreement over all these necessities. We pray for those that need salvation. We pray in Jesus' name that today is their day. Today is their day where they will encounter a living God, where they'll realize that you are the way, the truth, and the life, that no one comes to the Father but through you. So, Father, in Jesus' name, draw them into the cross, oh God. We just declare their salvation. We receive them saved and healed. We receive them, Lord God, walking in the Spirit, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, oh God. Give them a thirst and a desire to be in your word, to seek your righteousness, oh God. And in Jesus' name, help us, Lord God, to become instruments to be used to bring others to Christ as well. And Father God, we pray for a miraculous healing upon those that need healing in their bodies. Touch Pastor Carmen right now, Lord God. Touch her body. Touch those kidneys, Lord God. We speak life into those kidneys right now in the name of Jesus, oh God. And we just declare a supernatural healing upon her body. We lift up Mama Rosa, Lord God, to you right now. And just strengthen her as well. Lord God, build her up in the name of Jesus, oh God, that even now, Lord God, she will be strengthened and built up as she's recovering, Lord God. Strengthen her, Father, in the name of Jesus. And Father, we pray for all those that are sick in body right now, that are being affected by all this pollen and all these allergies. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, provide for every need in their lives, Lord God. Heal people right now of cancer and diabetes, Father God, and high blood pressure, hypertension right now, Father, in Jesus' name, Lord God. Let a supernatural power be loosened upon them right now in Jesus' name. And Father God, we pray right now, Lord God, for chains to be broken in people's lives, for chains of addiction, for chains of depression, that they will be broken right now in Jesus' name. We speak that over them right now, Lord God. We pray that chains of bad habits, Father God, and slothfulness, Father God, will be broken in the name of Jesus. And God, we thank you for your freeing power. You said that he who the Son sets free is free indeed. And we declare that promise over them right now in Jesus' name, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, that today they are free and they are whole, Lord God, in Jesus' name. And Father God, we pray for your divine provision, Father, that you will provide for every need according to your riches and glory through Christ Jesus. We pray, oh God, that you'll provide, Lord God, financially for everyone right now that's hurting financially. Father God, make a way for them, Lord God. Give them fresh opportunities, jobs, businesses that will thrive, oh God. Direct them and guide them and lead them, Father God, so that you could provide and prosper them right now in Jesus' name. Promotions that are coming their way even now as they have been faithful, Lord God. In the little, you will give them and make them rulers over much in Jesus' name. We pray, Father God, for your provision spiritually, Lord God, that you will prosper them. You said, Lord God, that we'll prosper spiritually. Every good thing that we have, that will grow, Lord God, and become closer and become more like you, Father. And Lord, in Jesus' name, mentally and emotionally, Lord God, let there be healing right now in the the name of provide, Lord God, for every need that they need. Let them know that everything is found in you, oh God, that they will not go to sources outside of you, but that you are the provider of all things, oh God, in Jesus' name. You said that every good and perfect gift comes from you, and we receive every gift and every provision in Jesus' name. We pray for the healing of relationships right now, Lord God, for coming, for stepping in right now and restoring marriages, restoring relationships with families right now in the name of Jesus. Let forgiveness be extended by everyone to each other, Lord God, that they can walk in forgiveness and in grace and in mercy towards each other, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And Father God, we thank you, Lord Father, for all that you're doing. We thank you, Lord Jesus, even now for meeting every need. And Father, I thank you right now, and I pray for peace over people's hearts, over people's minds right now. Let that peace that surpasses all understanding cover us right now as we pray, that we'll be anxious for nothing, oh God, but we'll bring every request before your throne and know, oh God, that peace covers us and surrounds us, oh Father, as we unload all our cares, as we cast our cares upon you, because you care for us. And we thank you, Lord God, for the victory. Hallelujah. Lord, we receive answered prayer. We thank you that everything we brought before you is being done. Everything on our list right now is being manifested. And in Jesus' name, we celebrate the victory. We celebrate salvation. We celebrate healing and provision and freedom for the captive. We celebrate it right now. We thank you, Lord God, that it is being done. And we thank you, Father God, that in your time, in your moment, Lord God, we'll see it all, Lord God. And we just thank you, we praise you, and we give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Listen, give the Lord a good praise right now. Come on, somebody. Just give him praise and glory and honor this morning. Woo! I don't know about you, but I'm just excited today, man. I'm so excited to be with you. I'm so glad you joined me. I hope you're being encouraged every morning. I know it encourages me to be here with you as well. So praise God. And listen, remember that pray. One of my prayers that God will ignite the fire, the passion for souls. Let's keep praying for people to be saved, that God will draw people to the church, amen, and that they'll see the fire of God and they'll be led to Christ. And remember, today's Double Dose Tuesday, right? Tonight at 7 p.m., Pastor Martin will be on with the intercessory team of New Life Outreach Church. They'll be on their call, right? On their prayer call. So make sure you tune into that prayer call and let's pray again. And I want to thank you guys for all your prayer requests. Keep bringing them in. Listen, put them in the chat every time we get together. Put them in there because Sister Lisa, who's on the line with us, who's our online campus coordinator, I tell you, isn't she doing a great job, man? Put your hands together if you believe. Just say amen, Lisa. God bless you, Lisa, for all your effort, for waking up early with me every morning, waking up with all of us to be there for us as well. Amen. Well, listen, let me just pray over you right now, the prayer of blessing. Heavenly Father, I just thank you for my brothers and sisters. I pray you will bless them and keep them, oh God. Father God, shine your face upon them and be gracious to them. Lift up your countenance towards them and give them peace in Jesus' name. Listen, God bless you. Enjoy the rest of your day. It's going to be a beautiful day. Just walk forth in God's presence. Walk in the Spirit. Amen. Because remember, when you're walking in the Spirit, you won't fulfill the desires of the flesh. God bless you. This is Pastor Carlos Rivera with New Life in Richmond, Virginia, signing off this morning. Amen. But remember, Lord willing, we'll be right back here at 7 a.m. tomorrow, like we do every weekday, for the Walking in the Spirit program. God bless you. Have a blessed day.